So the latest major update to Windows 10 has arrived. It's 21H2, so 2021, second half, and you can get it optionally right now if you go into the Windows Update settings, and it should be there as an option to download and install, or it will be rolled out automatically at some point, probably over the next couple weeks or so, but I think Microsoft has accelerated that. Now, even though this is a major update technically, which happens about every 6 months as a feature update, this one doesn't really have as many as you may have come to expect, especially in the fall, mostly because a lot of the features that were meant to go into Windows 10 21H2, you may remember this was going to be called the Sun Valley update, those just ended up in Windows 11, and they didn't really get added into this update for Windows 10, unfortunately. That being said, there were obviously changes, so we can go over them, which ones the biggest are, even though a lot of them are kind of behind the scenes, still worth talking about. Now, first of all, the first big change doesn't really have to do with the operating system itself, but rather the update cadence. Now, I actually thought that with the release of Windows 11, that Windows 10 would stop getting feature updates after this one. It would be the last one, but that's not actually the case. It turns out that Windows 10 will still be getting feature updates, just not every 6 months, but once a year, which will also be the same cadence as Windows 11. So it kind of is because every 6 months, the updates weren't that big, so they probably figure, why not just once a year release a slightly bigger one? So that's actually kind of a nice surprise if you still are going to be using Windows 10. They're not going to be completely neglecting it. Of course, some of the best features that they add might only be going into Windows 11, but still, you might get something. And specifically, Windows 10 support will extend until October 14th, 2025. Anyway, let's get into the actual big changes and updates to the operating system itself in this update. So the first one is a new Microsoft Store. You may know that as part of Windows 11, Microsoft redesigned the Microsoft Store, which is basically the Windows Store with apps and stuff. Now, technically, if you're splitting hairs, this isn't exactly part of the 21H2 update. However, it is starting to roll out at the same time as it. So even though you might not get them at the exact same time, they're rolling out at the same time, so I'm still going to consider it part of it. I actually do think that the new Microsoft Store does look nice. You can see here the general layout. Now, mine is a little bit glitched right now, probably because I'm in the preview channel, but it's not showing all the images, but you can still get a general idea of the layout here and look up some pictures I can put here of what it's supposed to look like. And also another big change that is supposed to be coming with this new Microsoft Store eventually is actually it will support not just universal Windows platform apps, but also Win32, you know, regular kind of programs. So you might start seeing a lot of your favorite apps showing up on the Microsoft Store that weren't available before. Though apparently for some reason the Microsoft Store won't be allowing Win32 apps to be automatically updated through the Microsoft Store, which kind of would be, I think, the biggest draw for it, but maybe they'll add that later. It's not compatible. Maybe in Windows 11 they'll do it. I don't know. We'll see. Now, the rest of the main changes in this update are more behind the scenes things, so I won't be able to show you much, but hopefully I can still describe it. One of these is that Windows 10 will now support the WPA3 hash-to-element protocol for Wi-Fi. So you may know WPA2 is the security protocol for you type in a password to encrypt your Wi-Fi, and then there's now the WPA3, which is not super universally supported, but still rolling out. And then now it also got an update to WPA3 called H2E, hash-to-element, which basically just adds some security against certain types of attacks. So if you're using WPA3, it should be more secure. Next, the Microsoft blog said there were security updates for the following. They weren't specific on what these are, but it's for Windows AI platform, Windows app platform and frameworks, Windows apps, Windows cryptography, Windows fundamentals, Windows input and composition, Windows kernel, Windows media, Windows office media, and Windows virtualization. So security updates across the board, it seems like. Also, they added GPU compute support in the Windows subsystem for Linux and Azure IoT Edge for Linux on Windows deployments for machine learning and other compute intensive workflows. Not sure I fully understand that myself, but I know that Linux is popular for machine learning tasks, and now a lot of that apparently will be also supported in the Windows subsystem for Linux, or at least improved so for using GPUs for calculations and stuff, I guess. And the rest of these changes are mostly enterprise level stuff, but I'll still talk about them. So what they say is Windows Hello for Business introduces a new deployment method called Cloud Trust to support simplified passwordless deployments and achieve a deploy to run state within a few minutes. Now, I again had no idea what that means, but I did look it up and someone on Reddit basically described it as just an improved way of handling a certain type of authentication protocol called FIDO. I know there's the one FIDO FIDO U2F, which are security keys. Not sure if that's exactly related to this, but apparently whatever this authentication method is, it's going to be a lot faster instead of potentially being hours before. Now here's a change that might actually be relevant to you. They say that Universal Print now supports print jobs of up to 1 gigabyte or a series of print jobs from an individual user that add up to 1 gigabyte within any 15-minute period. Now again, that does apply to enterprise level systems, but if your work does use Windows Enterprise products and Universal Print specifically, then it might be easier to print massive, large documents now. And another enterprise level update that seems actually significant if you are going to use this is that the mobile device management system now has over 1,400 settings that were previously not accessible. So if your IT department uses mobile device management, then apparently they have a lot more to work with now. Now, those are all features that were added, but there is actually one feature that was removed, which is syncing the timeline feature across devices. I've never actually really used the timeline feature, let alone syncing it across devices. The timeline feature is still there, but apparently now it won't sync across devices, so that's just the thing. And also some notable things that were not added apparently. One is DNS over HTTPS. This is a really disappointing one because this is one that was actually in a lot of preview builds, which basically would allow native Windows to support encrypted DNS queries, which is kind of important, I think, for security. A lot of web browsers already support it, and I did make a video talking about how to enable it in web browsers, but it would have been nice to have Windows natively support it for all requests, but they didn't even add that apparently. That's really disappointing. I believe it was added to Windows 11, but apparently it just didn't make it into Windows 10, even though it was supposed to. And the final one, which I'm not really sure if it was added because they weren't clear yet, is TLS 1.3. That's the latest version of TLS, which is an encryption protocol, which if you see HTTPS in the browser, that's TLS. It's basically the successor to SSL, which you might know. Anyway, TLS 1.3 was supposed to be added in 21H2, but they haven't updated the table that shows it, and they have not mentioned it anywhere, so I'm assuming it wasn't added. And actually, most web browsers already have it built in, so just because Windows natively doesn't support it, the individual software might. Still, again, it would have been nice to have the latest version, but it's not really going to affect many things. So anyway, that's kind of it. Yeah, not exactly a major update, but a major update nonetheless. And also, I always forget to mention, but if you guys want to become a channel member, there's a couple perk levels. If you want to just help out for $2 a month, you can get cool emojis that are custom for the channel you can use in my comment section, as well as a cool badge next to your name. Or if you want to help out even more, for $5 a month, you can get videos early as soon as I finish them, usually the day before at least. Or if you want to subscribe and you haven't already, also be sure to click the bell next to the subscribe button and enable all notifications, because I only post about twice a week tops, so you don't want those getting lost in the rest of your subscriptions. Now, if you guys want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is the one I mentioned earlier, talking about how to enable HTTPS over DNS, or encrypted DNS in your browser. I'll go over a few different ways in different browsers over there. So definitely check that out. And thanks so much for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video.